He says, church, if you don't walk in the light that's given, it will be more tolerable for the land of Sodom in the day of judgment than for thee.
Very serious statement. When we pray for health, are we willing to obey? Is the question.
He said, John, you've got to take my people from this barren land to a higher and higher experience.
Whether ye eat or drink, or whatsoever ye do, do all to the glory of God.
And you can be beautiful only as you put on who? Our Lord Jesus Christ.
Till you and I behold Jesus and feel inefficient, we can never fulfill the work He has for us.
We are to move forward in faith and hope, expecting lasting from God.
Because He is the one that set forth the plan that we follow and reveal His image and character to the world.
Good afternoon. I'm happy to be with you. And Brother Dennis has made my work a little bit simpler. Brother Zach asked me to take a session or two regarding how to cook, the principles of cooking. And therefore, I'm here and I'm happy. Now, let's pray and begin, because only God should help us to understand that which we need to know. I cannot explain anything. I can only be a medium. God has to do His work. Let us bow down and seek the wisdom of God through the working of the Holy Spirit amidst us. Let's pray. Our Father in heaven, we thank you for this wonderful afternoon. We are privileged to learn your word, Lord. And we are happy that you, the eternal Father, is willing to teach each and every little child your way. Lord, may we understand the truth for this time. May you speak to us now through the power of your Holy Spirit. May He cleanse us and fill us with your word. May the light be appreciated by each and every individual. Give me the words which are from the throne heaven above. Lord, may they be very simple. May they be expressed in the manner which can be understood by everyone. Lord, may you work through me and in each one of us. Lord, thank you, because you have promised each and every blessing for those ones who ask you in all earnestness. At this moment, we commit this time into your hands, submit ourselves. We ask these few blessings in Jesus' holy name. Amen. I would like to ask you a question. When you were told that, you know, we would be learning about cooking, what was your expectation? What were your expectations? Oh, you want some recipes, wonderful. Then? Pardon?
This is the perfect,
okay.
So there would be a particular method where we can cook everything.
Ah, particular method where we can cook everything. Okay. Everything good. Okay. Any other thing? Fine. Recipes, we will talk about it later. The time also being very less, we would like to discuss the principles of cooking. But before that, in this presentation, we will be seeing why cooking and what is the objective of cooking, and we will try to gather a few principles, and we will note down one by one. And I'll be telling them, so you make a note of them. I have made a note of this, those principles, so that you will be able to refer it in one go. So we proceed. Why is the cooking? Our work is to show the people how they can obtain and prepare wholesome food. How they can cooperate with God in restoring themselves His image. What is the purpose of cooking? It is finally the restoration of the image of God. I wish our people, the mothers, they understood this very well. See, many to many people, I am sorry, I don't mean to hurt anyone, but many ladies have forgotten how to cook. Lot of dependence is there from outside. But for us, cooking should be a pleasure because it is preparing us ourselves in restoring His image in us. So cooking is very important when it comes to salvation. I think this would have been read by Brother Dennis, but still I repeat, the health reform is an important part of the third angel's message, and as a people professing this reform, we should not retrograde but make continual advancement. It is a great thing to ensure health by placing ourselves in right relations to the laws of life, and many have not done this. A large share of sickness and suffering among us is the result of the transgression of physical law is brought upon individuals by their own wrong habits. Health reform plays a major role in restoring the image of God, and if people have been slack to have right relations to the laws of life, then we are making a dangerous thing. Now, when it comes to cooking, please take note of this one important matter I am reading. Our ancestors have bequeathed to us customs and appetites which are filling the world with disease. I stop here. I pause. Our ancestors, they have been transmitting the diseases to us because of the customs and appetites. Now, do we have a custom in cooking? Yes. Maharashtrians cook in a particular custom. People from Tamil Nadu, people from Bengal, people from Karnataka, people from Kenya, people from other places. Each place has a particular way of cooking. A custom is in, has been practiced. And we have that. Our ancestors have bequeathed. Bequeathed means they have passed on. That is our heritage. We have this heritage from the customs and practices from our parents, filling the world with disease. Okay? The sins of the parents through perverted appetite are with fearful power visited upon the children to the third and fourth generations. The bad eating of many generations, the gluttonous and self-indulgent habits of the people are filling our poor houses, our prisons, and our insane asylums. Why people behave madly? Why our houses are become poor? Why prisons are getting filled up? It's because of bad cooking, bad eating. See, the sins of the parents through perverted appetite, perverted, corrupted appetite. Appetite is the, what does appetite mean?
Hunger.
And any other meaning?
Feeding.
It is simply feeding, the kind of foods that we feed, the desire to eat. Yes, that's appetite. We have no right to wantonly violate a single principle of the laws of health. Christians should not follow the customs and practices of the world. We have been asked to separate from the world, right? Our customs and practices should not be according to the world, even in the matters of cooking. Let's go to 1 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 31. We know this word by heart, but let's read chapter 10 verse 31. Whether ye eat or drink, or whatsoever ye do all to the glory of God. So whatsoever ye do, the cooking, should it be to the glory of God? Dressing, our house, washing, cleaning, everything should be to the glory of God. God is interested in matters of even eating and drinking. Why? Which was the first sin? It was on the point of appetite, eating. God had restricted something and the man desired to have that very thing. So, we have no right to destroy our health. Those who serve God in sincerity and truth will be a peculiar people, unlike the world, separate from the world. Their food will be prepared not to encourage gluttony or gratify a perverted taste. Now, what is the principle? First principle, the food should not be prepared to encourage gluttony or to gratify a perverted taste. We learnt in the previous slides that we have been transmitted from our parents what? The perverted taste. Now, we should not prepare our food to gratify the perverted taste, but to secure to themselves the greatest physical strength and consequently the best mental condition. The physical body affects the mind, and therefore the food should be prepared to get the best physical conditions and the best mental capabilities. Let's go to Ecclesiastes chapter 10 verse 17. Ecclesiastes chapter 10 verse 17. What does it read there? It comes. Yeah, the princes eat in due season for strength and not for drunkenness. Drunkenness is the gluttony, gratifying the perverted taste. So, we should eat for strength, the physical, mental and the spiritual strength. That is the desire of God. In order to render to God perfect service, we must have a clear conception of His will. This will require us to use only healthful food. Only healthful food should be used if we should have a clear understanding of His will. What did Jesus do? What did Jesus say? Father, I have fulfilled your will. Jesus never violated the principles of health. Okay? Prepared in a simple manner. Take note. How should the food be prepared? In a simple manner. Note down this word. No, these are the principles. It should be prepared in a simple manner, that the fine nerves of the brain be not injured, making it impossible for us to discern the value of atonement. We are learning about sanctuary, right? Whose atonement is it? By who? By Jesus Christ. And if we eat wrongly, if we do bad cooking, then will we be able to understand or discern the value of the atoning blood of Jesus Christ? Will we be able to make it to heaven if that is not so? And the priceless worth of the cleansing blood of Christ, is eating all important, or is cooking all important? But you need to study how to prepare nutritious food. Food should be nutritious. First principle was it should be
simple.
Second, it should be nutritious food prepared in the most simple way. Take note of the adjectives used there. Most simple way. Most simple way. And still you may study to prepare appetizing dishes. It should be tasty, it should be inviting. In as simple and healthful a way as possible. It should be as simple and healthful as possible, so that the fine nerves of the brain will not become weakened and paralyzed, making you excitable, nervous, and easily provoked. Why do people have difficulty in having a balanced behavior? Because they are easily excitable, nervous, and easily provoked. And that is because of not eating simple food prepared in a simple manner. Do we understand? Is it salvation? Amen. Let's go further. It is of vital importance to know how to cook. Poor cooking produces diseases and bad tempers. Why do we quarrel in the church? Why do we fight? Why do we accuse? The system becomes deranged, and the heavenly things cannot be discerned. There is more religion in cooking, in good cooking, than you have any idea of. Religion has to do with cooking. See, look at this statement here. Died because of bad cooking, died because of sour bread, died because of medication, died because of an abused stomach. This might be written over the graves of many. Died because of bad cooking. So can the person who is cooking may lead to death of someone? The person who is cooking at home, can he or she be the cause of death to someone? According to this statement? Okay. What about salvation, if that is so? Surely, I have not included that statement here. Actually, the PowerPoint that I prepared got corrupted. I am using a PowerPoint which I prepared maybe 1 year back. I thank Brother Yob, he is preserving. My sisters, do not place upon your tables food that is exciting and irritating, but that which is plain. Food should be plain, wholesome, and nutritious. Simple way, simple food, plain food, wholesome food, nutritious food. It should not be exciting, irritating, disturbing the fine sensibility of the nerves. These are the principles we are gathering, we have gathered till now. It is the duty of the physicians to see that wholesome food is provided, and it should be prepared in a way that will not create disturbances in the human organism. This is speaking with respect to the food that is provided in the sanitariums to the patients, but nevertheless applies to us. And a simple, wholesome, palatable diet is to be provided. Now, look at this. There is to be no starvation diet. What is starvation diet? It lacks the vital elements of the food. What are the vital elements of the food? Carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins, minerals, fiber. Praise God. It should not be starvation. Some people take only carbohydrates. Some people take only heavy fats. Some people take heavy proteins, always grams, heavy grams. Some people will be taking only water unless they are fasting. That is not advisable. Yeah. So we should be practicing no starvation diet. It should be well balanced, well nutritious food, but cooked in a simple and healthful manner. Wholesome articles of food are to be combined. Now foods have to be combined. Wholesome articles have to be combined in such a way as to make appetizing dishes. So God is allowing combination of foods. Let's take that principle. Now, if these children had been trained from their infancy to take only healthful food, prepared in the most simple manner, see, the words are getting repeated, simple manner, preserving its natural properties. Please underline this word, preserving its natural properties. I will ask you to repeat these statements. Preserving its natural properties as much as possible and avoiding flesh meats, grease and all spices, the taste and appetite would be unimpaired. Somebody says, some people say, oh, if I do not take spices, I cannot take. See, it says taste and appetite would be unimpaired. It's a promise. Oh, I can't do without pepper. That's an easy statement, but you know, God says something different. God is wise. He knows even without these things, our taste is unimpaired, because we will be cooking healthful, wholesome, appetizing, nutritious dishes. In its natural state, how should the food be? Almost in a natural state. In its natural state, it might indicate in a great degree the food best adapted to the wants of the system. In a great degree, it is best suited for the wants of the system. You know why we have diseases then? Because it's not cooked in a natural way. It is devoid of nutrition. It is not adapted to the wants of the system. It is not taken in the most natural form as much as possible. And therefore, we have diseases, we have weak minds, we have weak bodies, we have weak understanding. You can underline the word in a great degree. The foods are best prepared, okay? They have poverty stricken diet. Food is prepared without painstaking and there is continual sameness. Now, what is the caution here? Food should, you know, some people go to kitchen, whatever that is available, just to manage time, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes only available. So, mix something, whatever that is. And sometimes somebody will be very hungry, immediately, what is it called? Instant food. They prepare instant foods and they serve it to their children and their spouses without any pain. Today, we have many things sold in the market where things can be prepared within minutes. Yeah, 2 minutes, instant. That's not the order of God. Person who is cooking should take pains to cook. Yeah? Because Jesus also took pain to relieve us from the bondage of sin. We should understand. And there is continual sameness. Every day, people are used to take only chapatis. People are used to take only rice. People are used to take only suji. Continual sameness. And you know, usually it happens when people go to buy vegetables, every day they will be bringing same kind of vegetables because they like that only. They don't want to try something else different. There should not be many kinds at one meal. First one says there should not be continual sameness. The second paragraph says there should not be many kinds at any one meal. How many varieties do we usually have in a particular meal? Indians? No. 5, 6. If we go to any function, it will go up to 16, 17, 22, 24 items, you know, different kinds of foods in one meal. Too much of variety. Yeah, for the lack of time, brother, you have to excuse me. Maybe I can, tomorrow I can do that. Yeah? Okay, please remind me tomorrow. Thank you. But all meals should not be composed of the same kinds of foods without variation. Yeah, you may cook 2-3 varieties, but all made of corn, all made of rice, all made of wheat. No, that is not the plan of God. The plan. We should have variety of foods in one meal. At the same time, it should not be too much of varieties. And every meal should not be the same kind of food. Okay. Are we getting the principles? Okay. Care should be taken. Listen here. Many of us try to make a rule. Many of us will be following this. Not all foods wholesome in themselves are equally suited to our needs under all circumstances. Foods are good. Watermelons are good. But do we prefer to have it in winter? No, that's a food for summer. Jackfruit is a food for summer. Okay, it's not suited for all circumstances. Let's read. We will understand that. Care should be taken in the selection of food. We should select the food. Our diet should be suited to the season. We should cook according to the season, to the climate in which we live. Okay. According to the season, we should cook. In a warm climate, we should be able to provide a certain kind of foods which are meeting the needs of that particular season. In a cold climate, we should be meeting the demands of that season. So, a lot of learning has to take place. We need to learn a lot of things, right? Okay. And the occupation we follow. A farmer cannot be eating the same thing as that of a clerk, and a clerk cannot and should not eat the same food which farmer takes. You know, when I work in a farm, my food intake will naturally be double. When I used to do hard physical exercise, my food used to be almost 2 to 2.5 times more than what I am taking now. So it depends on the occupation. We cannot make a particular pattern of food for all people. That should be understood. And some foods that are adapted for the use of one season or in one climate are not suited for the other. So there is different foods best suited for persons in different occupations. often food that can be used with benefit by those engaged in hard physical labor is unsuitable for persons of sedentary pursuits or intense mental application. Now, this is a caution. Do not have too great a variety at one meal. 3 or 4 dishes are a plenty. At the next meal, you can have a change. How many are plenty? 3 or 4 are a plenty. They are not few. When visitors come, how many dishes do we cook to please the visitors? When there are relatives, how many dishes do we cook? Many, right? 3 is more. 3 is a plenty. Then that means the allowance is only 2 kinds of foods. But with nicety, with nutrition, simple, as natural as possible, we should cook foods. Don't practice too much of variety. I'll give you the reason why. Much injury is done to health by variety of foods, food which is seen on so many tables. Take the different dishes that are placed on the table at one meal and put them all together in one vessel. Stir them up together. Does it make the stomach turn to look at it? Leave it for few hours and it will ferment. So, greater a variety of foods in one particular meal, it will be fermenting. And what is the result of fermentation? What is the byproduct of fermentation? Alcohol. Thank you. So, how will we behave? Like a drunkard and like a person who is intoxicated. So, we may not drink liquor, but our foods will in that stomach turn out to be liquor by eating a variety of foods in a meal. Okay. Now, 8,000 compel their stomachs to receive just such a mass as this every day. Half masticated meat, condiments, spices, spice and sweet puddings provided in a particular meal. Is there not sin in placing upon the table such a variety at one meal? Wow. Too much of variety in one meal is a sin. Often the desire to return to moral integrity is expressed. We often think that, oh, we should be morally perfect. But what happens? But this will never be until we return to simple, healthful foods. Until we eat and drink to glorify God, not to gratify our perverted appetites. Can we have moral health without having the nutritious, healthful food? No. Okay. I am not talking about nutrition. This is not a nutrition class. Otherwise, we should be discussing as to what to eat, what not to eat, which are good and which are not good, which are wholesome, which are not wholesome. The cook should tax her inventive powers to vary the dishes she prepares for the table, and the stomach should not be compelled to take the same kinds of food meal after meal. Here, there is a point which is stressed. Usually it's the ladies who prepare the food, and she should not prepare the same kinds of food in each and every kind of, at every meal there should be variety. You know, some interesting thing was observed I was told that this refrigerator is abused, the use of that is mistaken. I heard this many years back. That there is a person known to us, she, the mother, prepares the idli or the dosa dough, which is required for the whole week, and keeps it in a refrigerator, and every morning that's the food. No variety, no change. Same food taken from refrigerator and served at the table. Brothers and sisters, we should understand that the Israelites did not have refrigerators. Every day manna used to fall fresh, except on the seventh day. God bless us. What are the foods that we need to take? Fruits, grains, and vegetables prepared in a simple way, free from spice and grease. Grease is the hard oil, okay, of all kinds. Make with milk or cream. See, she was writing this long, long ago, but this principle of milk or cream doesn't apply to this day today. The most helpful diet. They impart nourishment to the body and give a power of endurance and a vigor of intellect that are not produced by a stimulating diet. People say that if we take vegetarian food, they will grow weak. They cannot do strong work. They will not have endurance. But do you know, most of the athletes, they are vegans. Why? Because they understand this principle. Though not from Bible and spirit of prophecy, I think nature would have taught them. Okay? So, it is these kinds of foods, fruits, grains and vegetables, they give nourishment, they give power of endurance and a vigor of intellect. So, our food should be prepared using fruits, nuts and, sorry, food, grains and vegetables along with grains. Nuts have to be included. Okay. I read from the, sorry, from here. Our bodies are constructed from what we eat, and in order to make tissues of good quality, we must have right kind of. Oh, we are so much attached to the customs and traditions. We want to eat like the way others eat. We want to have foods that which others take outside in the world. People who have no knowledge of God. We want to have our own customs. Oh, we are from Bengal. We need to have sweets every meal. Oh, we are from Andhra. We need to have that, you know, chili. Oh, we are from Tamil Nadu. We need to have that rasam. And it must be prepared with such a skill as will be best adapt it to the wants of the system. It is a religious duty for those who cook to learn how to prepare healthful food in a variety of ways so that it may be both palatable and healthful. It should be palatable, it should be good to taste, and it should be healthful. Poor cookery is wearing away the life energies of thousands. More souls are lost from this cause than many realize. It deranges the system and produces disease. In the condition thus induced, heavenly things cannot be readily discerned. Now, I stop this at this point because the time is running out. I will go back to some of the principles which we understood, and I want us to repeat once again. Food should be simple. It should be cooked in a most simple way. Simple a manner as possible, and it should be as natural as possible. It should give all the nutritive elements to the body. That means our cooking should not destroy the nutrition. Okay? It happens. You know, people come and ask me, how can we eat the food without spices and chili? We need spices and chili. It's because the nutrition value of the original food cooked is lost by our heavy cooking, and we need to provide something from outside. But when we learn how to cook in a simple way and how to retain all the natural properties, including the vitamins and the enzymes which are there in the foods, they give natural taste to our taste buds. We need not require many things that which we are using. And I have discovered by grace of God that this is true. At our home, we enjoy the food, because that's the way God wants it. You know, simple, nice. See, always man is complicated, God is always simple. When we understand this principle, our life will be very easy. You know, sometimes when my wife is sick, I get into kitchen, I come out in half an hour's time. The food is ready. I'll invite everybody, and they are serving, they are eating. Vegetables, I cook only for 8 minutes. 8 minutes. We will understand the principles tomorrow also when we deal. But it should be wholesome food prepared in simple manner. Only healthful food should be taken. Only healthful food should be taken. And not too many kinds of food should be prepared in one meal, and every meal should not have the same kind of food. There should be variation in every meal. There should be variation, like millets, wheats, different kind, you know, rice, jowar, etc. It can be varied. Like in a week, we can cover maybe 10 to 12 types of grains, maybe 6 to 8 kinds of grams, maybe 15 to 20 kinds of vegetables. Don't you see? Oh, we like carrot, and we use always carrot. Somebody likes, maybe cabbage, and they, cabbage. I know Kenyans, they like cabbage. Corn and cabbage, they are staple food, always they like that. We like rice, South Indians. North Indians, probably you have wheat always. But we need to balance it out, okay? And selection of food should be based on season, occupation, and then climate. Okay? We will expand this tomorrow. And any other questions, we will address it tomorrow. Is that okay? Fine? And I thank each one of you for kindly bearing me this extra little time during the hour which is supposed to be for lunch. Nevertheless, we praise God, because God is also so much long-suffering and patient towards us. He wants to teach us many things which we have not understood. And when every day I learn new thing from God about cooking, you know. Even yesterday I was learning something. It was reading, people in hot climates, if they avoid sugar, it will be easy for them to handle the warm climate. See? We eat a lot of sugar or sweets, and then we say we are sweating. That's the learning that I got yesterday. Anyhow, praise God, and let us thank God by praying, and then let us submit ourselves to whatever that we have learnt and understood. May God bless us all.